Alright, how's it going, everybody? Silent Ninja 31 here, and welcome to the pregame show. Before the MBHL playoffs, it is Game 1, the WID Outlaws versus the St. Paul Phantoms. With me today is BrosGo12. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Thanks for asking.
Alright, so let's get this pregame started here. We're about 5 minutes away from opening faceoff. The St. Paul Phantoms looking pretty good, except for their key player, which is Somb and Eric. 1, 2, 3. And what do you think that'll have an impact on going forward in this game?
I don't think it's going to... Like, I think Thunder and Sombra have a pretty good chemistry from what I've heard of, so I don't know how it's going to affect Thunder's play, but I know he is a big part of the team, so I know it's going to affect them, goal-wise, anyway.
And obviously, so many storylines in this Division A matchup. Obviously, the Windosaur Outlaws barely making it into the playoffs, just 1 point ahead of the Boston Revolution. Now that they're here, now that all that is settled, what's your outtake on them? Do you think they got a chance at SPP, maybe Tupelo, maybe the finals?
I think, depending if Smallsy starts coming to games, I think, yeah, they have a chance to win this series. Depending if they keep Aura in net or not, they could win, seeing now that there's only Eric and Thunder here. I don't expect SPP to be active, so maybe they can pull it off. No clue.
All right, and let's talk. Obviously, the key player for the Outlaws here, League 17, right?
Yeah.
A very, very dynamic player. You know, a lot of people said that he basically carried WID into the playoffs. What's your take on that? Do you think he's the Lone Ranger here in WID, or they got more talent?
Yeah, I think him and Arn are a pretty big part of this team. I think Link carries defensively for this team, and he's a pretty good on offense. So I expect him to play pretty well in this series.
All right, and just before we head to opening face-off here with about 3 minutes to go, we're going to take a quick commercial break. But before we do that, we do have one of the players on the line. Epic, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Epic, how are you doing today?
I'm all right. How are you?
Doing well, thank you. So you got SPP. You're in the playoffs. You got SPP. What's your outtake on SPP? Who do you? What's your just scouting report on them?
The last time we played them, it was rough game. We lost, God knows what. I think it was like 6-1, something like that. But they're missing Somber, which was a key part in that game, so I think that could change it.
So obviously, their leading forward now is going to be pretty much Eric Bossy. What do you guys have to do to contain him and have him have a bad day today?
I think we need to be very solid defensively. I think Link needs to play out of his skin, and our forwards need to be on top of their game and score goals on Clorox.
All right, and speaking of Clorox, he's been an excellent goalie this season. Anything specific that you think that you need to address with him, or is it just fire at the net and hope he makes a mistake?
Fire at the net, hope he makes a mistake. Setting up some plays. I think we've been getting better and better at that over the season.
All right. Well, good luck to you, sir.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, it is MBHL playoff hockey. It's WID and SPP. We'll be right back. And live from the Oracle Arena here in St. Paul, welcome to the MBHL playoffs. I'm Silent Ninja, along with my color commentator, Brosgo. And just as we're about to start, before the pregame, we didn't know Somb would be here. But lo and behold, he has arrived. And how does that change the game for Outlaws?
That's just a huge scoring advantage for the Outlaws here. I just really think he's going to have a good game today. We'll see, though. We'll see.
All right, so let's get to your starting lineups as a face-off is just about to happen. We're just waiting for the players to get their line changes. Let's start with the away team, the Windsor Outlaws. They're going to start with Epic Python, Link 17, the leading goal scorer for the Outlaws, and Bleeding Blue, a.k.a. Boris, known in the MBHL. In net, interesting choice. They go with Jacob and YR, otherwise known as Ara. Do you think Jacob's going to have a big responsibility here?
Yeah, especially since Somber's here now. He has Eric and Somber to deal with, so obviously going to be a big game for him needed today.
All right, and with the St. Paul Phantoms, they got the double dynamic duo, 20-plus point scorers, Eric Bossy and Somber Villa out front. Behind them, it's going to be Thunderhawk 12. And in nets, a great goalie that really revitalized SPP, Koroxt. And just looking at this lineup, what do you got to exploit if you're at the Outlaws?
I just got to say, you got to get some tips on Koroxt. That is his weakness in the game. You got to get past Thunder, who's a very good defenseman. So we're going to have a tough game here, but we'll see.
All right, and face-off is on their way. Welcome to the MBHL Cup playoffs. All right, it's going to start off with Link 17 up in front in the SPP zone. Goes for a shot that just rolls wide. Eric Bossy tries to take it out. Front danger here, Koroxt almost losing it out in front, but Thunderhawk will clear it to the side. Trouble here, Somber is AFK. Oh, Jacob NYR just wide of the post. And almost the first goal of the MBHL playoffs. This one's crossed, goes wide. Somerville is still away. This is going to spell trouble for the SPP here, as they're playing with virtually a man down. Alright, Thunderhawk clears that one all the way down. Bounce off the boards. And it will be Link 17 who's playing back a bit more. Interesting choice for the Outlaws. Epic Python trying to forecheck there, but he lost it to Thunderhawk and Epic for some... Oh, they're calling for the 2v2. Eric out in front shoots just wide. Eric, the rebound cleared away by Jacob and YR. Clorox out to play it. What do you think of this early start so far?
I think SPP is coming out strong here in the beginning. I think they're going to cap one off early.
Eric out in front shoots just wide of the net, and Boris will take it behind his net. Link 17 rushing ahead, but Boris is going to lose this to Thunderhawk. Thunderhawk out in front. Might lose it. The puck goes on play. And early pressure by SPP. What's the Outlaws got to do here?
I see they're just struggling to contain the puck. You know, they got to start passing it around, you know, getting the open ice.
All right, face off here. It'll be Eric that will take it. Link 17 removing his hat, leaving his bandana on. As Link's been a high advocate for the advantage with removing your hat. So what's your take on that?
I don't know. It's just some people just remove their hats for a lift on the ball, apparently. I don't know. It's something about that. And it makes their shot faster, apparently.
Well, we'll see how it plays a factor here. As Eric Bossy tries to get the puck back. Thunder goes for a shot!
That's a goal!
SPP up 1-0! Thunderhawk 14. And what a snipe there by Thunderhawk, eh?
Beautiful shot by Thunder, right past Jacob.
Run through right the five hole there. And SPP up 1-0. Is this what you expected from the early game?
Yeah, they applied the pressure, and this is exactly what they needed.
Well, let's see if the Outlaws can respond as Win 17 goes to take the face-off. Somerville is still AFK. Link 17 wins the face-off. This will bounce off the boards. Clorox plays it with his stick. Thunderhawk goes for a shot again, just wide. It's out in front. It's gone.
That's an own goal.
2-0. And you want to describe what happened there?
Slow mix-up with Jacob. I don't know. You can't let that happen in the playoffs.
And an early 2-0 lead, under 2 minutes. As Thunderhawk does get his second, he's been stepping it up in the playoffs.
Yeah, he can shoot the puck, I can tell you that. Or ball, however you say it.
Alright, and we're also going to have a goalie change as Boris will enter the nets. And I have no idea where Link is on the ice. Alright, we got a hit on Link. So, Aura will now play, looks like he's got to play some defense. And Boris will be in net. Link 17 goes for a shot that goes wide. Thunderhawk collects the rebound. Takes behind his net. Clears it out. Eric will get there first. Eric takes it. Goes for a shot wide. Ticked away by Thunderhawk. And Link 17 will get one of his first touches on the ice. And how do you think they've been doing on containing Link so far?
I think they've been doing well since he hasn't been able to control the puck that much. This whole entire first period.
Well, Link takes it, goes for a shot, just wide. And the irony of you saying that. Oh, Link 17 on front off the post. Link goes for the rebound, scores! Outlaws, within one.
What a talk. Exactly why you need to cover him. That man is dangerous on the ice.
Well, one of the biggest things is that he never gives up on the play. And that's evident just from what you saw in that goal there.
I think Winsler needs to take advantage of Somber being AFK right now. Because he is the biggest threat. So I think they need to take out the ice and apply more pressure.
Well, Link 17 never giving up on that play. And that's what makes him one of the better players and the man who quote unquote carries the Outlaws as Link 17 will get this puck back. And he's very good on those e-clears as well.
Yes, very good on the passes.
Alright, it's Link 17 who's gonna actually take his time on this. Takes the puck on his backhand, goes for a shot. Easy block there by Thunderhawk. And Thunderhawk will go for a shot. And Aura playing some forward here. This one will go all the way down. It's gonna be Eric that takes the puck. Eric waits, fire, saved by Boris. Shots on goal even so far, 4-6. And this one's going to go high, out in front, but nothing to go there. Thunderhawk takes the puck, forehands, and carries this one to the corner, where Eric will do his work now. Tries to get past Link, off the boards. Eric tries to e-shoot it, couldn't find it, and Clorox steps up to play it.
Thunder almost got a touch on that ball.
And here's Link taking on his forehand, gets through everybody, but on Clorox. Jacob NYR racing for the rebound, shoots just by the net. Thunderhawk kicks it again. And very slow pace, kind of, to this game after 3 goals within 4 minutes.
Couldn't agree more.
Link 17 takes the puck now. Goes for a shot! Ooh, just wide of the net there. Jacob NYR clears it inside. Tries to get the forecheck going, but Eric's on a breakaway now. Eric Bossy waits, fires, just wide of the net. And now Eric's gonna take it in the corner. He's still holding it. Tries to take it out wide, but good defense by Link there.
Uh-oh, Somber's back.
Somber is back, so let's see if the referee will call 3v3, your referee tonight. The commissioner of the MBHL, cool hockey player. And Link 17 takes it on his backhand, goes for a shot. Save, all goes through! Jacob goes for the rebound, but he just couldn't find it. And Clorox, little bit of a struggle here so far, but he's been doing all right. Dynamic will change, though, because Somber is now on the ice, and a 3v3 will ensue. So let's see how that changes the game. Somber playing hard forward. Oh, shoot, scores! It's Eric Bossy who makes it 3-1 for SPP.
A little bit of commotion on the ice for Boris.
Boris, angry that they called the 3v3, but Hopiism was the one that put him on. And this wasn't the first time that they called the 3v3 in the middle of play.
No, this is actually, I think, the second time they have done that.
Yeah, and
obviously it costed them a goal, so.
Boris definitely unhappy with the goal, as we've hit the 5-minute mark halfway through the first period, and it's 3-1 SPP. It's a very high-scoring game. Let's see if Link and the Outlaws can respond, as Link will take the puck. And taking his time with it, goes for the backhand that just clears this one down. It's over to Eric, who shoots. And Thunderhawk with a rebound opportunity here. Thunderhawk will just send that one in for Somb. Somb has no help here. Goes for a shot saved by Boris. Somb will take it out wide. This is very dangerous. Scoring territory for him as he goes wide. Shoots immediately. Just goes wide of the net. Eric Bossy, opportunity here. Boris got stuck. But nothing came out of that. Here comes Thunderhawk. Shoots. Blocked away by Epic Python. And now, opportunity here. It's a 3-on-1. This one goes wide. As Jacob, Link tries to find it out front, but this one will roll down. Bounces up for Somber. Somber tries to bounce it up. Oh, Jacob NYR does it well to clear. And now it's going to be Thunderhawk. Loses the puck here. Opportunity, but Thunderhawk has a lead on it and does well to get that around the net. Clorox with a block on Link. Great teamwork by him as Somber will take this one. Immediately shoots, but blocked away. And now Link takes out his backhand. Shoots, saved by Clorox. Rebound by Jacob. Just wide of the net. Force stepping up. Tries to get it away from Eric, and he does well. Getting the trap worn. And shoots, saved by Boris again. That was Thunderhawk with the shot. And now out in front, Clorox just missed it. Will roll wide, and Epic Python out in front. Misses everybody. Eric Bossy, a 2-on-0. Eric tries to find Somb. He does! But just wide of the net.
Save.
Saver just wide of the net. We're not sure, but this one will roll out wide and will roll over for Clorox. Clorox shoots wide of the net. Boris controls it. Sombervilla takes it around as we hit the 3-minute mark in the first period. Somb shoots just wide. Somber again. Opportunities after opportunities for SPP. What's WID got to do? As Eric goes for a shot, rebound by Somb, can't find it. Eric, on his forehand, waits, yes. Fires. Oh, it's over to Somb, shoots, saved by Boris.
What a save.
And scores! Sombervilla with the E shot, and it's 4-1 for SPP. Did we honestly expect this to go this way?
Just because Somber's here, I think the scoring has been better for SVP earlier here.
Definitely.
Man, this is very upsetting for Winslow.
Somb definitely is a game changer. And that's what's going to happen. The playoffs as Clark goes, shot shoots wide. Somber in front. Tipped away by Epic. And Somber tries to find it. It's there. Oh, how did that not go in?
Wow.
That was amazing. As Thunderhawk will step up, tries to shoot wide of the net, pokes up. Link 17 races for it and clears it out wide. Going to go to Jacob, but Clorox gets there and shoots. And Boris with the save flings up on the ice. Somb, taking his time with it, tries to clear it past. Looks like Epic. And Sombra on front now just loses it. Thunderhawk stepping up. Goes for a shot. Just missed it. And now WID could not get that. Sombra again shoots. Eric almost tipped that in. Eric now tips it out in front. Goes to Boris, but he did not connect with that one. Thunderhawk goes wide. Out in front for Somb. Eric trying to get it. Eric sends it around the net. And now Somb to the outside. Somb takes it, shoots, saved by Boris. Somb again, E shoots. And this one will clear down to Thunderhawk. Opportunity, but Link takes it, shoots, couldn't find it. Jacob NYR racing for it, but Link decides to shoot himself. It's going to bounce off Clorox. Fails the clear. Still gets out, though. Eric Bossy shoots wide of the net, trying to go for Sombra here. And just over a minute left to go in the first period. SPP leading 4-1. Link 17 stepping up and takes on his forehand. Opportunity here for Link, but a weak shot just wide of the net. Clorox tries to clear Link. Tips it, couldn't find it. Shots on goal in favor of the Phantom, 17-9. Eric goes for a shot that's just wide of the net. Somb takes it, fails the shot, and this one will roll to the corner now. And what's the shot on goal difference tell you about the game so far?
It just tells me that SVP is dominating this game so far.
And Boris stepping out to play it, misses the puck there, gets the trap worn. Epic tries to play it off the boards to Jacob with just over 20 seconds, hitting 20 seconds now. Epic loses it to Jacob. Jacob can't get past Thunder. Thunder tries to pass to Eric too hard there. Eric going for a shot here, and can he find it? No, he can't. Thunderhawk stepping up to play it. Can't find it. Jacob, this one will roll to the corner, and that will end the first period. And amazing first period for SPP. WID still has the ability to come back, but this one's going to be hard.
Oh, your mic is like lagging out.
Oh, it is? Okay. I don't think it will for mine. All right, we will be right back when the second period ensues. And we are back here in Oracle Arena in St. Paul, as we're just about to get the second start. But before we get to the action, what's your take on that first period?
Very dominating performance for St. Paul here. Maybe Winsler can make a comeback. No idea. But as of now, the shots are very uneven, as you can say.
All right, let's get back to the action here. And this is bad. Link 17 having some trouble with some lag here. And this is trouble because Link's all, just their powerhouse. They might have to 2v2 here. Alright, it's Somber Villa, and it's taking to Thunderhawk. Clorox was there, but Thunderhawk's going to take the puck back. He goes for a shot that goes wide of the net. Eric misplays it, and Jacob, NYR, no Epic Python, takes this here. And in Ooh. Front, Jacob can't find it, but Link out in front, shoot, saved by Clorox. And now Eric's going to take this puck. It's going to go over to Somb. Somb takes it. Oh, just lost it. Oh, Somb. Uh-oh. Miscommunication. Uh-oh. Out in front. But Link back there to play the puck. And Link takes it behind. Somb errors there. Link is lagging hard right now.
Oh, my.
He does get the clear. It's going to go over to Jacob. Jacob passes wide and goes to Eric. Elba loses it. Everybody loses it. Shoots wide of the net. And did Link DC here? No, he hasn't. This one's tipped wide. Somber Villa has the puck. Shoots. Standing save by Boris. He wasn't ready for that one. As Somb goes for another shot. That just went wide. Lamb gets past. And now Aura, Jacob can't find it. Thunderhawk tries to play it. This one's rolling in front. Great save by Clorox.
Uh-oh.
Rebound by Lamb. Can't find the net there. Jacob takes the puck, rolls it out wide.
Oh,
and Thunderhawk got benched for some reason. And Lambin on front. Couldn't find the back of the net there. Here comes Epic. Epic wide of the net. And Clorox, racing for it, does get the clear. Epic Python now will take this puck and flings this one out wide. It's over to Clorox, who deflects this wide. Epic Python gets through him. And Boris takes it behind the net, tries to clear it, and he does so well. Thunderhawk tries to take the puck away, but now it's WID. Shoots save by Clorox. Lambit trying to get something going. And shots on goal have evened out a little bit. 15-20. So you could see the effort by WID there. Trying to get something going as this one rolls in front, but Jacob couldn't find the puck. Great coverage by Clorox to prevent him from ever shooting that. And now Somb tries to get it. Lamb loses it. Epic shoots wide of the net. Epic try number two. Does so well. Thunderhawk loses it to Jacob. No, clears it. This one rolling to the side of the ice. Epic shoots, deflected away by Thunderhawk. And different game than what you saw in the first period, but Somb can't find it. It's a different game from what we saw in the first period.
Yeah, surprisingly, they're playing better with Link on the bench. I have no clue why. Really doesn't make any sense, but they're getting some shots on net now. Aura had a wide open net, walked a little bit too in front of the pass, and couldn't get it in.
And now Thunderhawk will take the puck. Loses it. This one will deflect a lot wide. Lambit Lights, who checked in, has been making a big impact so far.
Yep. He's actually been close to scoring twice now, I think.
And Epic Python fails to clear. Tips it wide. Tries again, and he does so well. Thunderhawk all loses it to Jacob. Jacob can go for a shot here, but Somb does well to get back. Somb shoots high of the net. And Eric tries to take out in front. Deflected away by Boris. Somb takes it, clears it in. Somb can get his own rebound. Shoots just wide. Eric, again, takes on his forehand. Goes for a shot. Thunderhawk gets passed through Thunderhawk. Clorox goes for a shot. Hard shot that goes through everybody and will re-enter the zone of SPP. This one goes wide, and Clorox will play it now. Hard clear. Out in front. Thunder! Oh, almost on gold. And Thunder trying. Thunder's going to wait this. He's going to lose the puck to Jacob and Lambert out in front. Jacob can't find it. Over to Eric. Eric on his backhand. Opportunity here. Loses it. Jacob now. Opportunity as we hit the 5-minute mark already in the second period. Eric deflects it. Over to Somb. But Boris will deflect that. And this one will go into the SPP zone. Clorox to Thunderhawk. Oh, deflection by Lambert. Just wide. Clorox racing to get that puck. And he does clear it. Over to Eric. Over to Somb. Somb out in front. Scores! SPP 5-1. It's Somb from Eric. And what do you make of that goal?
I think this game is over. I don't know. SPP cannot be stopped at this time. Winsler trying, but I don't think they can get past Clorox.
Well, if you look at that goal, that pretty much sums up SPP. They have great teamwork. They have great chemistry. And it was just a tic-tac-toe play, and Somber is the one that ends up finishing it. That's pretty much SPP for you, and that's their biggest strength.
That's how it's been this whole entire game, apparently.
Yeah, that's their biggest strength.
Eric and Somber are two very good defensemen in this league. I can see them winning this series for St. Paul.
All right, it's Thunderhawk. Thunderhawk's been doing very, very well defensively.
Yeah, defensively, he's been clearing the puck when it's needed. He's been controlling the their side of the ice so far.
And, all right, it's going to go over to Lambert, but nobody goes for it. And now Eric takes it, tries to find Somb. He can't. It's going to go to Somb. Somb on his backhand. He's going to take his time with it. Great defense by Lamb. Lamb tries to contain his own rebound. It's going to go to Eric for a shot that goes wide of the net. Lamb misplays it. It's going to roll over. Lamb got an opportunity here. Shoots, deflected off of Eric. And Lamb now gets through everybody. Gets Thunderhawk. Thunderhawk clears. Lambert tries to step up, but Eric, opportunity here. Eric fires wide of the net. Somb containing the rebound, which that's another big part of this offensive pressure. It's just Somb has been getting all of Eric's shots, and Eric has been getting all of Somb's shots.
Many rebounds for St. Paul. Most of their goals coming from it.
Somber's
definitely been a big part of the game so far.
Somerville fighting with Link. Now for the puck. This one's going to roll.
Oh, that's...
Jacob will find it. And Thunderhawk racing for the puck now. Thunderhawk fires one. High of the net. And Eric now. Behind the net. Tries to get it out in front. Everybody misses it. Thunderhawk tries to step up for it. Link 17 shoots. Gets through Clorox, but will roll wide of the net. Jacob racing for it, but Somb looks like he's going to win that. Lambert lights, takes it, backhander, wide of the net, rebound by Lamb, and who can find it? It's going to be Jacob who goes for a shot, slow shot wide. Thunderhawk tries to step out in front, can he find it? Big pressure here, as Link's trying to force that one through. Link tries to get it, but it's cleared away by Thunder. Somb takes on his backhand, rolls over in front, and Boris will cover that. And tomorrow we'll get you with the other series, and it's going to be a great one. It's the Alaska Bears at Chilliwack, and what do you make of that series matchup?
Alaska's barely making it into the playoffs. I really think Alaska's going to lose in four just because they don't have the firepower, they don't have a good goalie. All they have is Cracker Jack, and I don't think he's going to be enough to beat Chilliwack.
And now Somerville, a bit of lag there, but shot saved by Boris. Great save there. Eric Bossy tries to take out in front. Jacob and Lambert are there to meet him. Rolls to the corner. Lambert tries to clear. He does well, gets through everybody. Thunderhawk again, goes for a shot, misses, and tries to get his own rebound, and shoots this one down the line. Now Lamb, who's playing more defense so far. He sends this one down, and it's going to be Link, who misplays that puck. Link trying to force it in off the corner. This one won't work. And Link tries to E-clear. Ooh, Clorox ready with that shot. Link out in front. Can't find it. Lambent. Opportunity here. Takes on his backhand. Shoots. Goes over to Link. Link shoots. Blocked away by Thunder. Oh, poor clear here by Thunder, but Jacob couldn't get a handle on that. Now Somb, just under the benches. And he was. This one will clear back down for Thunder to play. Shots on goal, 20-25. You can still see that pressure there, but it's just been SPP that's been capitalizing on those chances as Eric shoots wide. Somber Villa there, and Boris out of his net, and he actually does get the clear there. Clorox shoots Sue. Could have been dangerous, but Jacob does block it. This one goes over. Link can't find it. Link, can he get some offense in here? Shoots. Ooh, great save by Clorox. And this one's going fling all the way down just wide of the net there. Thunderhawk racing for the puck here as we hit 37 seconds to go in the second period. Much faster period as a tip there. Eric with a rebound. Can't find the back of the net. Now racing for it. This one's going to roll wide. Clorox steps up to play it. Clorox hits wide. Somb, a 2-on-1 here. Here's Somb. Goes for the cross. And deflected away by Lambent. Thunderhawk again. Thunderhawk, opportunity for a shot here. Shoots! Just wide of the net. Jacob NYR. Can he do something with under 10 to go? Thunderhawk will take this one. Deflected off the boards. And that will end the second period. So after 20 minutes of play, it is 5-1 in favor of the St. Paul Phantoms. Shots on goal in favor of the Phantoms, 27-22. Ladies and gentlemen, after this break, we will be right back with the third period of action. And we are back here with a third period. It is myself, Silent Ninja, and Bros Ghost covering the third period for you as this period has gotten started. Clorox with an early save there. And after two periods of play, do you think WID still has a chance?
With how Thunder's playing on defense, no, I don't think so. I see that WID is struggling to clear the puck in. It's obviously backfiring on them.
Oh, this one rolls on front. Boris steps up to play it and does get the lucky cover there. And that's been the story, is Thunderhawk getting it down to either Somber Eric and they just basically take advantage of that. And Epic will face the puck there. He does get the shot off. Clorox looking to go for a shot. Looks like that was tipped away by Thunder. Thunder stepping up to shoot. And this one will roll over to Somb. Somb, opportunity here, but goes through him. Jacob tries to clear. Can't do it well. Somber takes it, tries to find Eric. Wide of the net. Link racing back to get it. And does come out with it. Sends it down. Thunderhawk, lots of deflections there. Lots of danger, but WID still only with one goal. Shoots here, just wide. Somber Villa, very dangerous with those shots as he tries to find Eric. Puck goes through him. Eric out in front. Epic almost tips this in. Somber out in front, shoots, saved by Boris. Link out in front. And it's going to be Somb and Link fighting for it. Somb tries to find the center, blocked away by Epic. And Jacob sends this down. Clorox racing for it. Can't get it. Trap Warren. Thunderhawk tries to clear. Does so well. Epic Python opportunity for a shot here. Decides to just send this one down to Link. Link out in front. Deflected away by Clorox. And now it's going to be Jacob, who tries to find Link at that center there, but Somb fails the E shoot. This one will roll down for Thunderhawk. Thunderhawk again deflected away by Link, and Link stepping up now. Tries to find Jacob, who just gets it just wide. Jacob takes this on his forehand. He waits, tries to find Link. Good idea there, but Somb out in front. Somb shoots, saved by Boris. And Boris out in front. Oh, it's off the post! And trying to find it. It's Eric. No! Link coming out with it. Thunderhawk stepping up for it. And now Eric tries to find Somb. Can he do it? We don't know. Oh, Eric tries to find it. Deeks him. Somb. Oh, just fails the shot on a wide open net. Could have been 6-1 for SPP as Somb goes for a shot again. Goes wide. Jacob tries to step up for that puck. But Link 17 will take that himself. Tries to get it to Jacob. And Thunderhawk does some great defense there. Jacob tries to take it on his back. Oh, tries to shoot it. Can't find it. And Eric will take this one. Eric tries to get it on his forehand. Can't find the puck there. Jacob shoots. Blocked away by Thunder. Jacob again tries to find the center. Blocked away by Clorox. Thunder having some struggles here now. And Jacob will send this one around the net. Despite Thunder's struggles here in the third period, WID can't capitalize.
Yeah, great save there by Clorox, by the way. Just the dominance of Thunder being on defense is just crazy. It's just, they can't capitalize on all the chances they've had.
And let's take no credit away from Clorox, too, who has been fantastic this game so far.
Yes. Very good season from the rookie. No, I think he's a rookie. From the rookie goalie, Clorox.
Oh, this one out in front. Oh, Jacob can't find the puck there as Thunderhawk will take the puck from him. Thunder tries to take it on his forehand. It's going to go around the net now, racing for his Clorox, who does clear it. Well done there. And now Somb loses the puck. This one will go out to the center. And let's touch up on that Chicago-Alaska series. Obviously, one of the biggest stories is that their starter is going to be Skate OP in net. What's your take on that? Do you think that that Skate can find a way to get them past the onslaught of Cracker?
Well, obviously, they've lost a huge, probably top three goalie in the league, Holpeism, who's now having a computer problem, but I think Skate will be able to, not as good as Holpe, but be able to fulfill the position of goalie for Chicago and hold them off.
All right, and we got to a 2v2 here as two of the players have left, and Epic Python will take this puck. Oh, over to Somb. Somb has an opportunity here. Somb E can't find it. Epic shoots it towards Boris, and Somb can't find the back of the net there. Eric Bossy with the puck now. Backhands it just past Link, but Epic will be there to play it. Epic will send this one down, and Clorox tries to take it. Blue line worn there. Boris tries to block Somb, and he does so very well, giving time for Epic to clear, but Somb does get back in time. Somb goes for a shot blocked away by both players for WID, and Epic trying to race for it. This one will go around the net, and Link looks like he's going to get first touch. And talking about Link, he's been having a sort of quiet night after that first goal.
Yeah, he just hasn't had, with last season, he hasn't had the teammates to back him up. I mean, not calling them bad, but doesn't have the firepower to help him. But I think he'll be able to get better throughout this series.
And for the Outlaws' sake, we do hope so, as the next game will be either tomorrow or the day after. So it's Link now. Link tries to find the center, but Epic's not there. Epic shoots wide of the net, but Link couldn't tip that one there. Link tries to take it around as we hit the 4-minute mark in this third period. And if all stands, SPP will have a 1-0 lead in this best-of-five series as Somb goes for a shot saved by Boris there. Epic goes for the clear. Can't get past Somb. Opportunity for Eric, who fails the shot. And Eric now sends this one over to Somb. Somb takes it, shoots. Ooh. Good save by Boris there. And despite the five goals, Boris has been playing very, very well.
Well, I think three of them came from Jacob, so, I mean, he's been holding off strong in net for all the shots that he's faced so far.
And Epic goes for a shot that's deflected away. And Eric tries to race for it, but Thunderhawk, who was checking the game for Somb, has some good defense there. But Epic on front! Oh, just can't get past Thunder. And now here comes Eric. Goes for a shot high of the net there. Thunderhawk racing for it. 3 minutes to go here in this Game 1 series. And Epic Python will take this one to the backhand. Save by Clorox. Arguably one of his best saves on a rather quiet night for him. He's been making his saves.
Ooh, uh-oh.
And Epic, ooh, good clear by there. Right there. Eric goes for a shot wide of the net. And Epic steps up for it. Goes for it. And Link 17. Link now takes it back. And shoots. Oh, what a goal by Link 17! As the chat just broke for me, so we can't see those reactions, but man, that was, what a goal there.
Wow, that's an amazing shot.
What happened there? Was it a curving ball?
I think what happened was, it was just a fast, I think Clorox was in a C position, so it wasn't able for him to spread out enough to save it. Obviously, it was a great lower corner shot, so very hard to save.
Despite the goal, a little bit too little too late here.
Yep.
And
sadly, Epic, it is.
And Epic will take that face off. And that just goes to show how much Link is just trying for this game. But, you know, I definitely agree with you that he really doesn't have a lot of offensive firepower. Boris has been playing great ever since he checked into the game. But, oh, Boris with a shot there. But he's just not, it's just not enough to hold off Eric and Somb, and now Thunderhawk, who's played fantastic, getting two goals, I believe.
Yeah.
And here comes Link, just got his third goal of the night. Link will race this one down, 2 minutes to go here in the third period. Link goes for a shot that's deflected away by Clorox, and this one's gonna go on front for Epic. Oh, just fails that one. And Boris now goes for a shot. Ooh. Ooh, gets through him, but just wide of the net. Oh, out in front, Link 17 couldn't pick that one up.
See, this is why they should have played like this all game. Now they're like clearly dominating in this third period.
And here comes Thunderhawk. Up to the first shot here. Tries to deke out Link. This one's gonna go to the side. And Thunder tries to play it. Can't quite find it. Oh, Link on his backhand.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Link shoots. Oh, just wide. I don't know if he was going for the shot or finding Epic, but Eric on a breakaway. Eric Boris stepping up. And does get the good block. Enough, at least, for Epic to get there. Boris shoots. Wide. Oh, goes through the five hole, but just can't find it. And now here comes Eric. Boris stepping way out of his crease. And Eric takes it in the trap.
Uh-oh. Oh, there we go.
Now loses it. Thunder lagging a bit here. And Link fires it wide. Link will take this one under a minute to go. Fires one, but blocked away by Thunder. Link tries to take it on his backhand, but he can't. Epic was not there. Thunder lagging a bit here, but we are under a minute to go, and Link will take this one. And takes this, goes for a shot, goes wide, and Link now loses it, and now Eric. Eric, opportunity here.
Oh,
and a lot of tips there, but it'll ultimately go to Link. Epic Python goes for a shot, can't find it. Eric racing for the puck, and this one will roll wide. And Boris fails the clear here. Does get the clear, saved by Clorox. And Clorox tries to shoot, but does deflect this one wide. It will go to Epic. And this one will be 1-0 for the St. Paul Phantoms. Winning game one here, 5-2. And what a game here. First game for the MBHL playoffs, really setting the tone for SPP.
Couldn't agree more.
Alright, well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this rendition of the MBHL playoffs. Tomorrow, it'll be the other series, the Alaska Bears will take on the Chilliwack Chiefs. And this one is over for tonight. Game one goes to SPP as they will lead the series 1-0. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching from Bros Goes and myself. We will see you next time.